Welcome to my class, and in continuation of the previous class in which we discussed about three important products: total product, average product, and marginal product with the help of a table in order to understand the law of variable proportions. That's what we did, and this is what we did, and see, this is what it is. In the last class we talked at length about these three important products: total product, average product, marginal product, that we get by putting inputs, which is varying one, that is labor, and keeping the other fixed. Okay, so based on that, what I did was I plotted the TP and MP into the graph, just plotted it. So we see the shape of TP, AP, how is it really, TP and marginal product, total product and marginal product, how they follow. For example, the marginal product just tells you about the rate at which total product increases. So there are three stages or three phases of the total product. That is, total product, when it increases at an increasing rate, marginal product is at its height. And when it starts falling and is positive, then total product is increasing but at a decreasing rate. And finally, when the total product falls, the rate shows that the marginal product is negative. So having said this, I must just tell you something, that in this, let's go back to what we did in the previous class. In that, we talked about the first we differentiated between the long run production function and the short run production function. And in the first differentiation, I told you that it is a production function, that is a short run production function, in which factor ratio changes. It tends to change with a change in the volume of output. So here, if you see, what I've done is I've shown you that, like, we've kept it as, say, let's take the fixed factor as say land and keep it at 2 hectares. So the factor ratio is changing. That means the output changes as the factor ratio changes. So is that clear? So what is the factor ratio? Initially it is 2 hectares of land to 1 labor, then 2 hectares of land to 2 labor, then 2 hectares of land to 3 labor. That's how the factor ratio is changing. As the factor ratio changes, the output changes. But in the long run production function, it is, the factor ratio does not change with a change in the volume of output. That means if we set a factor ratio, we take it as 1:2:1, or, you know, throughout we'll keep it as that. So that's a basic difference that I wanted to point out here. And in this, like, for example, if the input of one factor is increasing while all other factor remains constant, then the proportion between the factors is changed. Now suppose there are 2 factors of production, say land and labor. So this is land, which is given, and this is labor. So suppose there are 2 factors of production, land and labor. Land is a fixed factor and labor is a variable factor. Supposing you have land measuring, say, 2 hectares, you grow, say, groundnuts on it with the help of 1 unit of labor. Accordingly, the proportion between labor and land will be 1:2. If the units of labor are increased to 2, then the new proportion between labor and land will be 2:2. In other words, if there are 2 hectares of land per unit of labor previously, now there will be 1 hectare of land per unit of labor. That is if you see the average product. So on account of the change in the proportion of factors, there will also be a change in the total output, but at different rates. Initially, when more labor is employed on the fixed land, total output may increase at an increasing rate, but eventually a stage must come when, as a matter of law, total output will increase only at a diminishing rate. So this can be easily understood with this. So you see that it initially, and the point I've shown here is point P, that is the point of inflection. That is, till here, the product, the total product is increasing at an increasing rate and marginal product is at its height. But after this point of inflection, what happens is that the total product is increasing but at a decreasing rate. And tell me who tells the rate? How do you know the rate? That's a marginal product. Okay. So this is, and this actually is known as, popularly known as the law of variable proportions, or it is also known as the law of diminishing returns, or sometimes it's also called the law of diminishing marginal product. So in the next class, I'm going to talk about the law of variable proportions with the help of a diagram. Are we going to, now in that particular class, we're going to talk about the three phases. That will be our focus.